Hey everybody, this is Michael again, and welcome back to my channel here on YouTube. Continuing to give you my thoughts on all 28 original Japanese Godzilla films. Now, I'm on the 14th film in the series, guys, and that is Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla. But before I begin, some of you have written me and asked me, do I have any of the original Japanese releases of the Godzilla films? Well, unfortunately, guys, I don't have any of the actual Japanese releases from overseas, but I do have some films that I actually ordered on eBay a long time ago when I was kind of unfamiliar with, you know, the original Japanese films. And these, I believe, are actually Chinese releases of the Godzilla films. And I'm going to show you these films in my collection. I only have five of the films, but I'm going to show you regardless. The first one is Godzilla 2000. And here it is. There's the cover for the DVD itself. And the reason that I think these are actual Chinese releases is because on the back it says Chinese traditional and Chinese simplified. There's not even a Japanese language version of the film. So I have Chinese and English in all these films. Here's the back of it, guys. Gonna run through them kind of fast here, guys. But that's Godzilla 2000. And it's really no use for me to show you how the DVD itself looks, because it's really done in a kind of a mirror reflective kind of cover. So you're not really gonna see the details on the disc itself. I'll show you what I mean. See there, guys, you can see my monitor in there. You can see the camera there, but you can't really see the details on the DVD itself. Excuse me, Godzilla. Next we have Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla, the original Chinese DVD of the film itself here, guys. And the actual DVD is actually the same as the reflective one I just showed you, so no sense in my showing you that. Then we have Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla 2, the Chinese import of the film. I love that cover, by the way, guys. Here's the back of it. Is that Mickey on there? Yeah, that is Mickey. And the DVD on this you can see. There we go. Then after that we have Godzilla against Mechagodzilla. If you G fans are familiar with this film, then that cover there is widely used, so you've probably seen it before. Here's the back. Godzilla and Mechagodzilla are sniffing each other to see which one smells the best. Inside, you can see this one here, guys. Then finally, we have the film Mothra and King Ghidorah, Giant Monsters All Out Attack. And I love this cover, guys. I really love this cover. That is an awesome cover. Probably one of the best covers they've ever done in a Godzilla film. And even the back is pretty decent. There we go. The inside of this one is blue like the other one. Now, of course, you can't play these movies unless you have a region-free DVD player, which I happen to have, so I was able to watch all of these. Been a long time since I actually watched them, but there you have it. And also, guys, if you watch the videos, you heard me say that I wanted to get the Sony DVD releases of the Godzilla films, and that was because I was under the impression that the Sony releases had the actual Japanese titles of the film. Well, unfortunately, I was wrong. I found that out. The Sony prints are exactly the same prints used on the Kraken Blu-ray releases, so you don't have the original Japanese titles. And the reason I thought that was because I had downloaded a couple of films for the reviews that I didn't have at the time, and they actually had the original Japanese titles. So that kind of threw me for a loop, guys, because I'm thinking, well, you know, I assumed that those were the Sony DVD releases, but unfortunately, I was wrong. But I'm still glad to have these releases of the films, guys, because just from a collector's standpoint, they're really nice, a lot more nicer than the Blu-ray releases of the films itself. The cover alone is a lot nicer than the Blu-ray release. And I'm glad to have them, guys, because they're really, really nice, really, really collectible. So even though they don't feature the original Japanese titles, they're still very collectible. I'm really glad to have them in my collection. Let's put this back up here, minus all the glare. Okay, guys. The next film in the series is Godzilla versus MechaGodzilla. And this is the actual Sony release. I don't believe, at least here in America, that this film has been released to Blu-ray disc. Now, I saw this film a long time ago when I was a kid. And it's one of those movies that I thought to be very, very rousing, very, very fun. Kind of an epic Godzilla film. Just so much going on in this movie, from the brilliant score by Masaru Sato to the really innovative and thoughtful and charming special effects by Teruyoshi Nakano, to the excellent direction by Jun Fukuda. You know, a lot of fans feel that Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla is actually Jun Fukuda's best film, and I'm all with them there, guys. This is a very, very excellent film, excellently directed, very well made, and I have nothing but praise for this film. This is probably one of my all-time favorite Godzilla films. Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla, even to this day, seeing it about a couple of days ago, I still found that there's much to love in this movie. Very, very well made. Despite the fact, guys, that, you know, there's not a whole lot of originality in it. I mean, we still have the same story of aliens invading the Earth using giant monsters to take over. And then, of course, we have Godzilla and Gyrus in this. And then we have Mechagodzilla and then the new monster, King Caesar. So, like I said, guys, this is a film that I have a lot of fondness for. This is one of those movies that was pretty much a staple on Saturday morning matinee film television, and it was just a film that I grew to really, really enjoy. Now, once again, guys, here's the cover for that. This is a Sony release of the film, and they did a really, really excellent job. The picture quality in this DVD translates very, very excellently, and I would imagine if this was ever put out on Blu-ray, it would look very, very good. You know, I'm all a fan of Akira Ifukube's score for Godzilla. I think he's the best composer in the Godzilla series. But Masaru Sato, his score for this film is pretty doggone brilliant, guys. And it features a lot of music that's really, really refreshing, bouncy, totally fitting of the film. He done an excellent job on this film. And one thing that, you know, I really loved about this film at the time was the sense of consequence. I felt that Mechagodzilla was really a creature that could really threaten Godzilla. I felt that this guy was really tough. So the fights were really, really well staged, really, really well done. Definitely a sense of danger and consequence to the battles. And I know the first time I seen the film and I'm seeing Mechagodzilla, or the evil Godzilla, fight Anguirus and actually breaking his jaw, I thought, oh my goodness, this movie is serious. These monsters can get their asses really kicked in this film. We have some really, really brilliant miniature effects in the film. The oil refinery scene is something that I just always loved. I just really loved seeing Godzilla and Mechagodzilla fight in the oil refinery, because that scene is so well done. I'm watching this scene, I'm watching all the explosions, the fire, the heat, these actors being in these suits, and I'm thinking, my goodness, how the hell did they not pass out in all this extreme heat around them? It's already hot enough in the suits, but you have all these explosions, these fires and all this, and it's amazing that these guys could continue to act. But that refinery scene, that whole battle, is just brilliantly done. When you see it from a distance, you see the water and the refinery, Godzilla and Mechagodzilla fighting in the distance. It's just incredible. Just totally incredible. Then we have some really brilliant and beautiful scenery of Okinawa. And just a lot from a visual standpoint, from a cinematography standpoint, just a lot to love in this movie. Just a film that is just gorgeous and beautiful to look at. And I really like the actors in this film too, guys. I really like the actors. A lot of returning actors. We have the same actor that played Dr. Sarazawa in the film. We have the same actor that played the scientist in Godzilla vs. Mothra, or Mothra vs. Godzilla. So, you know, a lot of these returning actors, really, really great to see them. And the female reporter, also really, really nice. Just to me, the actors were very, very likable in this movie. I mean, you know, they're not very, very developed or anything like that, but they are very, very likable. I really like the cast in this film, all of them. the Interpol agent, just great in the movie. I mean, I liked pretty much everybody in this cast. Now, of course, Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla, when it was translated to American audiences, it was given the name Godzilla versus the Bionic Monster. And that was due to CinemaShare's knowledge that at the time we had the $6 million man and the Bionic Woman on TV, and both shows proved to be very, very popular. So they named the film Godzilla versus the Bionic Monster. But of course, when the makers and creators and producers of the $6 million man and the Bionic Woman heard this, they threatened to sue CinemaShares for copyright infringement on the name Bionic. So they changed the film to Godzilla versus the Cosmic Monster. And then of course, years later, we would come to know the film as Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla. But still, it is a wonderful film, guys. One of my favorite, all-time favorites in the Godzilla film series. And definitely one of my top three films in the Showa era Godzilla films. So I just really love this movie quite a bunch. It is just a lot of fun. One thing, though, about the film, guys, is that you have to wonder why Godzilla is always teamed with creatures that don't really do much to help him at all. King Caesar, kind of a neat character, neat in the fact of what he can do. They had mentioned in the film that the aliens say something like, "We must destroy him before he resurrects other monsters." They never really use that power in the film, but it would have been nice. But Godzilla's always getting help from creatures that don't really help him very much. I mean, Godzilla versus Megalon, he had the robot, which really didn't do a lot to help him. He could have fought the creatures by himself. Godzilla versus Gigan, Anguillus was pretty much useless to him. Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla, King Caesar was useless to him. So they're always teaming him up with monsters that don't really do much to help him until Godzilla gets the upper hand, and then they just come in and help him. But aside from that, guys, Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla, some really, really brilliant filmmaking in my opinion. I love this movie, and it's just simply one of my all-time favorite Godzilla films in the franchise, and definitely got to recommend this, and I definitely want to see this come to Blu-ray so I can give it a look. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. The next film, of course, will be Godzilla, or no, it won't. It'll be Terror of Mechagodzilla. Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and I shall see you at the next movie review.